before,
I'm afraid
right?
it's going to be one-sided because the PS4 players are savage. They are. No, but it's normal, you True. Know, it's because they have like more than 200 players participating in each tournament. Well, on PC, they had something like, I don't know, less than 100. So it's meant to happen. People compete with better players, so they get better themselves.
Pretty much, yeah.
So, yeah, the PS4 players are extremely dangerous.
All right, so it looks like Traitor has kind of finalized his decision on Sasuke. That's right. It's going to be a Sasuke versus Sasuke, isn't it?
So they might look extremely similar, but they're actually different. They have different movesets entirely, different powers, different ultimate attacks, different special attacks. It's not just the eye that switches. It's actually the whole new movesets, whole new animations, hitboxes, etc. So it's they look extremely similar, but they're not the same.
Yeah, one Sasuke has more issues than the other. So let's see how this is going to go down.
Well, the first Sasuke has really short combos. They do a lot of damage. The other Sasuke actually has almost no pressure on guard, but he has an extremely really good grab that he has. Mm. So it's really fast. He catches opponent off guard all the time.
Oh, nice.
All right. So Sanyin Sly is going for counter dashing and counter attacking in the air.
Nice.
Both players are being extremely careful right now.
I was gonna say for a few seconds, they look like they're missing a lot of what they want to do. But it's getting closer.
Well, actually, nice. Traitor caught Sanyin Sly in a combo, but he's sitting with no subs and once again the counter attack. So basically, if you jump in the air and hold the guard button, when your opponent dashes on your guard, you can press the attack button right away and you will counter attack. So that's what Sanyin Sly is doing right now. You use the counter to push the opponent off, getting some room to breathe.
If you guys are also wondering what the yellow glow around the characters, it's the storm gauge, and when that gets to a certain level, they can activate defensive stuff and basically attacking with more damage and allowing people to even save you from ultimate juices depending on the character.
Also, I believe we might mention that Danzo is probably one of the most powerful characters in the game. He has the ability to one-shot KO anybody in the game
once he awakens.
So let's see.
To keep in mind,
his Sanyin Sly is going to try to go for it.
Might be his backup plan.
Once again, the counter attack. He's going for chakra dash canceling, which allows you to keep your combos going.
Yeah.
By using some chakra meter. Once again, the counter attack. You can see this Sasuke is really good for counter attacking in the air.
Yeah. This is interesting.
But he's sitting with no chakra, which means he cannot dash anymore. But he's still going for the hair attacks. Okay, so if Traitor is being
like
careful...
I was going to say they're distancing each other, and it's like...
Well, Sanyin Sly is counting him, is like, not trying to...
Wait, what's happening? Why is it?
I believe he was waiting for him.
I feel...
Because,
like,
the thing,
Traitor's playing like a back, like he's run, like a...
Traitor has extremely defensive supports. He has extremely defensive support, so I believe that since Sanyin Sly had the advantage, he didn't want to take risks.
He didn't.
But sadly, his cockiness just cost him almost a round. Even if he does manage to win this, he's almost out of health. So the next one is
weird because Traitor's playing like far range, with a far kind of tactic with close range characters.
Those players are trying to wait for one another.
Yeah, it's a bit.
But right now, he only has one sub left, so Traitor has to be extremely careful.
Yeah, Traitor.
That being said, he's making Sanyin Sly waste his chakra. And Traitor does have the more health, right? I'm not... oh my god, he just got hit by the...
Oh! Well,
Shuriken KO, that is insulting. And it's like the 1% of HP that takes away the round.
It's kind of extending the match, this play style, but let's see if that will work.
Wow.
Oh, nice.
So yeah, Shiroran landing, he probably could not sub this.
Hmm.
I'm surprised. I would have thought I would have killed Sanyin Sly.
The
pushback, yeah.
Yeah, the pushback.
He's going to go for aerial combos because he knows this Sasuke has the best aerial combos in the game.
What do you think of the chances of him keeping this health? Until I'm proven wrong.
Here's the thing. When the opponent has almost no health, you tend to become very confident that you can take him out.
True. That is exactly the point right now.
Exactly. He has no HP, and Traitor thought he could take him out, and he couldn't. got cocky, and that happened. That being said, it's probably gonna lose real soon, but Trader has less than 50% of HP left, so the next run is going to be extremely complicated for him. And remember, he can awaken with Danzo, ascending Slayer, which would make him unbeatable. Yeah.
Sasuke's been able to keep a low health for a really long time, not even taking...
Okay, guard break, so there's one round everywhere, but Trader is sitting with only about 48% of HP left, yeah, which is not good.
What do you think? Could he pull it off? I think that on the, I personally think Simon, but what do you think?
I think their levels is actually much closer than I would have thought. Mm. But the problem is the team that Sinisla has is like a fail-safe team. Rene is using it in a fair way, but if he wants to take the fight, he can take the fight. With Itachi's perfect Susano and Danzo's Awakening, there's nothing that a Trader could do anyway. And he didn't need it, right?
He could have wrapped up this match, though, in two rounds. Oh, well, with a two-round win, if he had done that earlier, you know?
Yeah.
But, yeah.
All right, so that Sasuke counterattacking the hairs is godlike. It's
beautiful. Okay. So, well, Saiyan Slayer takes a match?
Yeah.
Yep. And I guess
That wasn't as one-sided as I thought it was going to be.
Like,
Trader is a really good player, but I feel like his team is not as strong as what Sanin Slayer was actually using. So here the matchup was not in the favor of Trader. I would say Sanin Slayer probably has a slight advantage. From the actions I've seen, I would say he's probably a bit more experienced in the game, but he was much closer than I would have thought. So.
Yeah, it's interesting. It was definitely nothing like the match before.
But here's the thing. Even though he looked close enough in some of the action, the thing is, Sanin Slayer, as I said, a fail-safe team. That he didn't have to use it, right?
Yeah, he didn't need to.
So he wasn't pushed to his limits. So I would say that he probably has much more under his sleeves. He's playing Nagato, apparently. Nagato is about one of the strongest characters in the game. He has probably the fastest combos in the game, so you can do full combos after a guard break, which is with full damage, which is ridiculous.
He's got really good combos for stumbling the opponent.
Yeah, you can dash at him while he's trying to combo you from afar. So
he's got the same thing that Pain has with his tilt now.
Yeah, he has the same tilt as Pain, so that's the almighty pull.
Yep.
Which allows you to, well, as the name says, actually pull things in. Whether it's the opponents or the supports. Yeah.
Yeah, and that can be really good for bringing down your aerial opponent and just messing up their flow.
But if you're too predictable with it, the opponent can actually jump and block, and then you're vulnerable.
And read you out, because then he pulls you to you, and then you kind of call your own death. It's on you.
All right, so Naruto support, they both took him. He's a really good support in the air. It has probably the best tracking in the game. So if you just jump and call Naruto in the air, you can be sure that he will actually hit your target, no matter what.
The funny thing is, right, Traitor's picked Sarada, who also has a stumbling move in her combo.
True, like, but it's only kunai. One...
one kunai.
Yeah, it's only on one frame of her combo that she does it. Nagato does it on pretty much every single frame.
Pretty much.
Nice right counter.
Right counter. Counter back.
Yep.
Counter savagery.
So they both have strike backs in their teams, which means if they do land another counter, they can actually get the bounce effect.
Yep. Which will make counters not so safe for the other opponent.
Ultimate jutsu combo.
Nice. Cancel into ultimate.
So in this game, beautiful. You have several ways to do team ultimate. I mean, I'm sorry if I say team ultimate. I mean ultimate. You have several ways to do ultimate combo jutsus. What happens is then, if you use your chakra within your combo, if you load your ultimate while you're doing the combo, it will do less damage. It's like a damage limiter.
Yeah.
But if you cancel your moves, your combo with like a ninja move cancel, which is trickier to do.
Oh my god. With a guard break, which is going to be much weaker.
Exactly. After
the
a guard break,
it's not going to be.
Same thing. Yeah. If you use a combo with the chakra loading and right in the middle of a combo and after a guard break item, the damage limiter is in place.
Yeah. So it is significantly weaker. But all the same, he got it off. He utilized that moment.
Yeah, it's still good to you know, get some pressure off and reset the fight. It's pretty good. Anyway, but that's probably going to kill. So Nagato has a sick staggering animation, as you can see, where he can just jump and dash back at you and you cannot get out of it.
Mm-hmm. And nice main kill with the aerial juice.
So if you were watching what he tried to do, Sanin Sly is basically using Naruto in the air to make sure that the opponent is, you know, stuck on the ground. And he's forced to block. So then Nagato has all the time in the world to pressure the guard, you know, and then the guard is about to break. Mm-hmm. It's very it's a nasty setup.
Technique. It's a really good pressure technique. You get the guard like
it's
down,
really hard
red.
To beat. So yeah. It's really hard to beat.
And Naruto's aerial jutsu and Pain's aerial jutsu?
Yeah.
Been amazing ever
because
since.
Because Naruto forces the opponent to wait in place. You cannot do anything to dodge it.
Yeah.
So and with combos that short and that powerful.
Look at that. It's crazy. Ooh. He has to be careful when he's using the Almighty Pulls, because he doesn't want to be predicted.
Yeah.
Do not want to be predictable.
But he has still one sub, I'm pretty sure he's waiting. He doesn't want to take any chances.
Saiyan Slayer wants it in the bag. Pain is a really good support. Look at that. He's put Naruto out of subs.
Yeah, and as you can see, Naruto is almost staggered.
And it's Okay.
Yeah, because that. Let me explain. And we have the first finish ultimate scene. What happened is that Nagato's ultimate is considered a projectile.
Yeah.
And when you sub projectile, you sub in front.
Yeah.
So what happened is that he subbed the first time, but he didn't block after he thought he would be behind him.
Exactly, and because the ultimate involves a projectile, it doesn't vanish. It stays,
so he subbed into it. That was a trap. That's what you call it. This is literally a freezing trap. So, yeah. Sanin Sly takes it.